My name's Raymond Crowe, and all this used to be my manor. We was all young then. They used to call us the tasty geezers, the white boys, the habitual violent criminals. Call it what you want, you know, it means the same thing. Yeah, we was villains. We broke the law. But, you know, we was something. We were legends. The steps just there. Could have gone up steps. Yeah, over there, in the corner where that cafe is, used to be an old girl selling flowers. She was there for years, had a little stall. Big Maureen. Don't know why we called her that. Name wasn't Maureen. People around here, they don't know me now. But I used to, you know. When I used to walk down this street back in the day, they knew me. You could see them looking at you with a look of sort of fear, you know. You could see them, it'd be like that. Or they look at you with, like, respect, you know, like that. Sometimes it'd be like a mixture of fear and respect. Can't really do that one. A bit more complex. Yeah, I mean, we was crooks. But, you know, it's different in those days. There was a sort of gentleman's agreement, you know, with the coppers. You know, we had old Dykey. He was our nemesis. Detective Inspector Dyke. He was a card. He used to drive down this road in his squad car. He used to see me and he'd go, oi, Raymond, like, you know, I'll just pretend, you know, I'll shoot you, you know. And I used to go back like that. I used to go, you know, I'll stab you. It's all in good humour, you know. Apart from when he actually was shooting me, you know, and I was stabbing him. We all used to have nicknames, you know. There was one of our gang, he was called Dog Chew. His real name was Tony. But he used to be this other villain, right? Called Chinese Johnny. Chinese Johnny, he used to use razors, proper cutthroat, you know. If you crossed him, out would come the razors, you know. And we used to call him Chinese Johnny because, you know, a brush with him meant loss of face. To get it?
Yeah. It was a Japanese phrase.
Is it? Oh. Anyway, so he pissed him off, right? Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. No, so Tony pissed him off. And he said to him, if you show your face around here again, I'll slice it off and feed it to my dog. And because Tony, he wouldn't be warned. He had a few drinks one night, said he's going back there. We said, no, you shouldn't. But he did. So Japanese Johnny says, actually, it sounds better, that, actually, doesn't it? Japanese Johnny. Yeah. So he says, I warned you, you slag. Out comes the razors. Slices Tony's face off, chucks it to his dog. Dog wolfs it down, blood everywhere. Ambulance come, police come. But of course, there's a code, you never shop anyone to the coppers, even your worst enemy. Tony just told the police that he'd done a particularly violent sneeze, so the police couldn't do nothing. But this was the early days of that microsurgery stuff, you know, where you could sew stuff back on. So one of the ambulance geezers, he goes, here, where's the face? Because they can sew it back on. And somebody said, oh, well, the dog had it. So I went, all right. And they were just about to go, and the dog threw up. And so they quickly grabbed the face and got it back. There was a bit of a struggle because the dog wanted it back, you know, and but they managed to get most of it. They whipped it down the hospital and scraped all the pedigree chum and stuff off it and sewed it back on. It's a 16-hour operation, but he got his face back, you know. As I said, it was early days. Got to be honest, didn't look great. Didn't look great. It's all a bit raggy, and the lips didn't quite, you know, match up. But he was all right about it. He got his face back. He used to laugh about it, you know. Tell a story down a pub. Well, I think he was telling the story. It was difficult to tell. You couldn't really understand what he was saying. But he was lucky, though, because there's another bloke called Tommy, because Japanese Johnny done him a few years before. Doctors couldn't do nothing. Yet they spend the rest of his life down face. Tommy the Skull, we used to call him. Lovely bloke. Always smiling.